Rabbana yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khayr wa bika nasta'in ya fattah. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Subhanaka la 'ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. There's a beautiful narration that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives each and every person an opportunity to gain closeness to the Almighty. This narration, within it, lies some extremely fundamental points and guidelines whereby we can attain true closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereby we can attain love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in a hadith Qudsi that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. No servant of mine will do anything except this act, and through doing this act, my servant gains closeness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِ بِشَيْءٍ. There isn't anything that my servant would do to gain closeness to me except that he gains closeness, and that is مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ, the first principle. Except a servant would do any of the compulsory obligations in the deen. Now sometimes a person may analyze salah and zakat and hajj. He may analyze the benefits in doing halal and staying away from haram. He may try to analyze so many different things that Allah has made compulsory. But the scholars have mentioned that those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made a priority in your life and my life, those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made as a compulsory obligation in the deen, are those things that Allah himself loves for his servant to do. So when a servant, first and foremost, if you want to gain closeness to Allah, then first and foremost we must do what we are commanded to do. For a person who may do the world of good actions that are nafil, but neglects his salah, he cannot gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For a person who gives the wealth of charity and have done so many good things, if he neglects the zakat, the hajj, these things, he can never gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every compulsory act in the deen, we should do. One, it is compulsory, but greater than that, in these actions lie the pleasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In my salah, when I perform my salah, I gain true closeness to Allah. Allah mentions in the Quran, wasjud waqtarib, that when you make prostration, make that prostration waqtarib, and you truly come close to me. This is why in sujood, a servant is the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He communicates directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the five pillars of Islam, in the shahada lies the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are forgiven for whatever sins may have been committed before. Your salah, your zakat, your hajj, and not only these pillars, but any compulsory obligation, kinship, family ties, fulfilling whatever covenants we have among each other, doing what is halal, staying away from the haram. These things are things and avenues to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It does not stop there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. And my servant, he continues to gain closeness to me, bin nawafil, with every optional ibadah and worship. So along with doing what is compulsory, if you want to gain the love of Allah, that is still not enough. My servant continues to gain closeness to me by the optional actions that he may do. The scholars have explained this in many different ways. The Quran he recites, the dhikr that he may do, the optional charity. Looking at all of the commentaries of this hadith, this wording, we can see that every opportunity of good, every opportunity of ihsan and kindness, every opportunity to exercise some mercy upon the youngsters, every opportunity to give that respect to the elders, every opportunity to do kindness to the elderly, every opportunity to assist your brothers and your sister, these are all optional actions. Allah says that when you continue to do what is compulsory, and you increase upon the optional things, the things that at times we may belittle, Allah says that my servant continues to come close to me, hatta, until I become beloved to him, and until I love this servant so much. Subhanallah. And this is the crux and the pinnacle of it. This, brothers and sisters, we must show utmost importance to. You know, sometimes our eyes are always falling upon the haram things. We are weak. Our ears, sometimes we hear the music. We may not have the music in our vehicle, but you hear maxi taxi passing and you hear it, and for some reason we start shaking. Or sometimes, for some reason, we are walking and we are doing something and we are intending to commit a sin. Allah says these two things, the compulsory obligations, the nafil, and every opportunity to do good. Allah says, and He promises, that أحببته, I would love Him, and I would become كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به. The ears that He used to hear, Allah promises, I would become that one through the means of which he would hear only good things. Some persons, alhamdulillah, may have been in our lives that every single time they hear of haram, they turn away. They shut off completely. Every single time they see backbiting, they turn away. Every single time they see any haram, they hear, they turn away from it. This is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah promises that if my servants do like this and they come close to me through the fard, the nafil actions, then I would become the ears for him to hear. He would always be inspired to listen to what is good. وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يَبَصِرُ بِهِ يَبَصُرُ بِهِ. And I would become the eyes that he would see. I would become the eyes that he would see all the haram that may exist in our society. We become blind by it. We cannot see anything that is haram. Allah would bless you and I with this opportunity to safeguard our iman, to safeguard our faith, our Islam, our deen, our good actions, brothers and sisters. It does not stop there. The narration continues. وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْتُشُ بِهَا. And I would become the hands that he would touch. And he would only want to touch what is halal, stay away from the haram. وَرِجْلُهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا. I would become the feet that he would walk with. Always walking to do what is good. Some narrations mentions, Allama Ibn Rajab continues, he says, two important things. وقلبه الذي يعقل يعقل بها. I would become the heart of that individual, that he would recognize, he would understand this deen. Allahu Akbar. I would become the heart that every single emotion that exists within him is to please Allah. Every hate that he may experience and that emotion would be for the sake of Allah. Every love he experiences is for Allah. Allahu Akbar. وَلِسَانُهُ الَّذِي يَنْطِقُ بِهَا. And I would become the tongue that he would speak. Allahu Akbar. I would become the tongue that he speaks. Sometimes we hear people may give long lectures and we are never inspired. Probably like today. My weakness. But sometimes some people would say some short, sweet words that you would remember for your whole life. You become inspired for your whole life. That is from the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The narration continues. And this last point is extremely important. We do what is fard. We do every kindness that we can do after the fard. And if my servant, وَلَئِن سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ, if he were to ask for me for anything, I would give him. وَلَئِن اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِذَنَّهُ, I would, and if he were to seek protection from the harmful things of this life, I would protect him. Subhanallah. This, brothers and sisters, could change your life and could change my life. Islam is not only about performing salah 5 times a day. Sometimes we become satisfied. Sometimes we become satisfied with a little good that we do. Always remember that shaitan at times may encourage us to even do good actions, but in a lesser degree. Sometimes shaitan would cause us to do sadaqah, but with the wrong intention. Sometimes shaitan would cause us to even perform salah, but for show. So if sometimes we become satisfied by the little good that we are doing, that is from shaitan, because a believer, he believes that behind him is a mountain of sins, and he needs to strive further and more to conquer the sins that he have committed. So a believer is always inspired to do more. So when we have fulfilled the compulsory obligations, let us extend our hands to do what is more. Let us extend our hands to build the relationships that are broken. Let us extend our hands to unite the ummah. Let us extend our hands to the poor and the needy. Let us extend our hands of mercy for the youngsters. Allahu Akbar. This is part of the deen. And so much so, you would suddenly realize that your heart beats Allah. You would realize your ears listens to only halal. You would realize you look and the sins have become disgusted to you. That when you look at haram, you feel upset. You feel disheartened. You feel disgusted by looking at haram. This is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Practice this one narration in your life. You would be successful. Let us start, brothers and sisters, with our own selves. Let us ask the Almighty to give us the tawfiq. There's no ability and power except from Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq, the means, the ability to implement every fard and compulsory obligation. It will be difficult. But with the motivation of knowing that in every fard act lies the pleasure of Allah, let us inspire each other to be better. And every window and opportunity to do good, whether it is a smile, whether it is a word of kindness, whether it is some sadaqah, Whether it is opening the door for your brother as he's leaving the masjid or as he's coming into the masjid. Whether it is imatatul adha anit tariq, removing something harmful from the pathway. Let us initiate with ourselves. Let us not wait to miss the opportunities that prevails themselves in front of us. As-sabiqoon as-sabiqoon, ulaika humul muqarrabun. The foremost and those who have surpassed everyone, they are the truly close ones to Allah. They existed at the time of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they exist today. One scholar was explaining that the sabiqoon amongst the ummah today are those that do not wait for anyone to do any good act. They do it themselves. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, forgive us, and bless us, and unite our hearts all with iman in this life and the next life. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ورسائل المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.